egg, telur. Okay, the test. Certain telur divided by 5 times. On doctor test, okay, bole. Another doctor test, only that. My telur, full. No problem, okay? But the senior, the higher, they have problem because everything should be checked. They are more dependent. But look at Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is totally different from this system. He is above this, beyond this kind of formalities. So Allah is a Samad. That's why I ask you to understand the meaning of Samad or not. This is my issue, that he is more powerful, is really, really independent. Means he doesn't need anyone's help. Maybe you can ask me now, okay, Ustaz, why this all this malakul? This is according to his choice only. But he is the one. A'udhu billahi minash shaitani rajim. Innama amruhu idha arada shay'an ayyakula lahu kun fayakun. Allah is the one. Whenever he wants to say to do anything, that's good. That will be done. Finished. Okay? So, Allahu Samad. You have to understand Allahu Samad by that verse of Yasin also. Kun fayakun. Okay? So he doesn't need any help. He doesn't need any help to do anything. Okay? Alhamdulillah. Now another one. Lam yalid. Lam yalid wa lam yulad. Lam yalid wa lam yulad. What is the meaning of lam yalid? He didn't give birth. Okay? For example, here begot is not used in our, we are not native speaker. It's better if we say birth. Okay? So he didn't give birth to anybody. Means he is not father of any children. Also, olam yulad. Also, he did not take birth by any mother or anyone. Okay? Meaning that he is free from this system. Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave this system of reproduction or this system only to maintain the generation. Only because of Allah's decision. We cannot change it. Whether you are Hindu, Muslim, Christian, all we have to follow. The natural system, we cannot. It's natural means actually given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, but Allah is above this system. He doesn't need to follow this system, okay? Lam yalid wa lam yulad. Wa lam yakul lahu kufuwan ahad. There is no one comparable to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why I told you yesterday about Zakir Naik, about Abdul Rahman As-Sumai. Did anybody check Abdul Rahman As-Sumai after you left? Maybe you forgot, okay? But just make a note, later on you check. 11 million people accepted Islam. Is it easy job? Ya Allah, Ya Allah. It's not easy job. If one person accepts Islam, whole patronage will, the news will spread very soon. You know of the Shahid? He came and then on Chinese lady was just observing and then suddenly she cried and accepted La ilaha illallah. It will spread even Malaysian newspapers, okay? But 11 million people accepted Islam. It is everywhere. You can search Abdul Rahman As-Sumai. How many masjids did he build? Can you imagine? 5,700 masjids. Or 5,500, I forgot. Is it easy job? If you just donate 10 minutes, you feel very happy. Alhamdulillah, saya sadaqa suda, alhamdulillah. Simple ringgit. Yesterday it was Satya Malaysia, Satya ringgit. I give you higher rank, okay? Simple ringgit, very happy. But 5,500 or 700 masjid, is it easy job?
No.
No, ya Allah. Only because of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He showed, I am still here. Al-Hayyul Qayyum is not just by you are telling, no, I am still here. So don't just cry when the Ustaz talks about Sahaba. No, still you have the example in this dunya, present time. Because Abdul Rahman As-Sumai passed away, most probably 2012 or 11, like that. Very recent, 4 or 5 years ago only. Ya Allah, Zakir Naik is still alive. So, these are the examples that Allah is alive. Allah is the most powerful. Whatever He wants to do, He can do it. Okay? So may Allah give us tawfiq to understand it. Lam olam yakullahu kufuwan ahad. There is no one. No one. And believe me, yesterday I told you that it is not learning the translation. You have to learn by observation, by your practical experiences. I told you many, many times, the door closed, fully closed, but Allah opens. You check, once you check and find it for is true, then you will never be misguided. Okay? So may Allah give you that tawfiq, that experience to check everything by practical, inshallah. But you have to concentrate seriously. You have to make a lot of dua. Then your heart is connected, only then you can observe. Otherwise, you will be normal believer. Okay? Try. Inshallah, you will get the test of your iman, test of your dua. Inshallah. Then your life will be changed. Inshallah. Okay? Again, decide. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Qul huwallahu ahad. Allahu samad. لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا احد Again. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل هو الله احد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا احد Recently I went to Brunei. So these two times. Last year I went for Quranic class, university, Islam, I can tell you English name, Malay name I forgot. The religious teachers, university college, Sri Begawan, okay? So they invited me to talk about this Quranic program, this year also. So this year I visited the Sultan's palace, okay? Look, because it's not like democratic country, it's like kingdom, okay, Sultan. So if you just see all the guards, no political party, no fighting, nothing. But system, everything is okay. Everything is prepared, ready. Even the guard comes on after another, and on group goes, another group comes. Because it's fully like, other estate, okay? So then I realize, for example, no political clash, no fighting, but still, Sultan enjoys or likes to have all the system. So if it is true for a sultan of a only very small land, so just think about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who created you, who is controlling all the resources, your petroleum, all the things in his control. So how come you are very reluctant, you are not serious to praise him? Cannot. You cannot do like that. And he is the creator, he is the controller of everything. So he puts the benefits for you in ikhlas class. He put the benefit in Fatiha. He put the benefit for you in la ilaha illallah. Don't argue. You argue, you fail. You surrender, you will enjoy. You will get the benefits, okay? So no chance to argue actually. We have to enjoy by his mercy. Inshallah, you will never forget, okay? So please try to make it as your normal habit. Regularly. Inshallah, you will get benefit. Amen. Now, we have another chapter, another grammar chapter. I already opened the slide. Look, before we learn this fala, falu, falta, faltum, all this, right? Now we have another. It's okay, I'm coming. So, for example, now you have to change the sign also. How? For example, before we say like this, now Amar order is different. Before it was a state, Anta. But now it will be like this. Ifal is order. Ifal, do. Ifal means do. Bual, okay, order. Ifal. Ifalu, plural. Buat plural is like this, okay? Ifal, ifalu. Ifal, ifalu. La tafal, la tafalu. Jangan buat like this. La tafal, la tafalu. Ifal, ifalu. La tafal. Again. Ifal, ifalu. La tafal, لا تفعلوا. Again, افعل افعلوا لا تفعل. Excellent. Again,
افعل
افعلوا لا تفعل لا تفعلوا افعل افعلوا لا تفعل لا تفعلوا. Again, make it easy. افعل
لا تفعل لا تفعل لا تفعل لا تفعل.
Again,
افعل لا تفعل لا تفعل.
With ماضي, with all together, okay? With ماضي مضارع and all together, okay? فعل فعلوا فعلت فعلتم فعلت فعلنا فعلت. مضارع يفعل يفعلون تفعل أفعل نفعل تفعل. Excellent. Well done. Then افعل افعلوا لا تفعلوا. Don't say Luna. Luna, then it will be مضارع. Okay, افعل افعلوا, not لونا. افعل افعلوا لا تفعل لا تفعلوا. Okay, so same pattern I taught you for ماضي مضارع like this. So for أمر نهي you have to understand, oh this is like أدرب, oh this is like إلهام, same like افعل. So you have to understand this is pehla amar, amar, okay, order, okay, ifal, ifal, ifalu. So if I say irham, irhamu, la tarham, la tarhamu, idrib, idribu, la tadrib, la tadribu, iftah, iftahu,
la taftah, la taftahu,
ij'al,
ij'alu, la taj'al. لا تجعل.
Excellent. Well done. Well done. Alhamdulillah. So I can sing the song now. Allah is one. He is the only one who created everything. Allah is one. He is the only one. La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah. Allah is one. He is the only one who created everything. Allah is one. He is the only one. La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah. Can you see the moon? Can you see the sun? Can you see the moon? Can you see the sun? Can you see the shining stars? Allah made them all. Can you see the shining stars? Allah made them all. Allah is one. He is the only one who created everything. Allah is one. He is the only one. La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah. Can you see the day? Can you see the night? Can you see the day? Can you see the night? Can you see the clouds high? Allah made them all. Can you see the clouds high? Allah made them all. Allah is one. He is the only one who created everything. Allah is one. He is the only one. La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah. Can you see the birds flying up so high? Can you see the birds Flying up so high, can you see them in the sky? Allah made them all. Can you see them in the sky? Allah made them all. Allah is one. He is the only one who created everything. Allah is one. He is the only one. La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah. Allah can see me. Allah can hear me. Allah can see me. Allah can hear me. Wherever I am, Allah is with me. Wherever I am, Allah is with me. Allah is one. He is the only one who created everything. Allah is one. He is the only one. La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah. Alhamdulillah, Allah gave the nur to Yusuf Islam. You know that the story of his Islam, acceptance of Islam?
Yeah.
How did he accept Islam? You know that story?
No.
Oh, okay, it should take time. Okay, maybe later. Or just in short.
Sure.
Actually, as you know, he was like Cat Steven before, and then another Michael Jackson and him together. I mean, at time it was like competition, who is higher. Sometimes Cat Steven's, you know, album was the like top-selling album. Sometimes like Michael Jackson's. But both, you know, somehow they got the nur of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay? So what happened? What happened to Cat Steven? I just, they have money, they have everything to enjoy. Just to enjoy alone, not even with any other. He went to, by boat or by speedboat, means like some, not cheap, small boat, to travel around the sea, okay? Yeah, it was the sea, okay? Just to go. Yeah?
Sailing.
So, yeah. So, then suddenly there was a strong wave, okay? So, very strong wind also, wind and oil. So, what happened? He fell down. And then the boat is far away from him. He cannot catch, he cannot go there. And then the wave is doing like this. No way, no alternative. Nobody can help him, nobody is near him. Mobile, everything gone, okay? So, because by this, become artist, most modern, artificial, this, you know, artist. So, now there is no option, right? No choice. So he said, oh, I am from Christian background. My parents practice religion. So if there is any God, help me. I will follow you. No way, right? So then he surrendered to God. God means in his belief, okay? Then a strong wave came from his back and then pushed him to the seashore.
Beach.
Yeah, beach, yeah. So very quickly, and then when he found him, that discovered him that he is just in the beach, and then he was really like very shocked, means like, what happened? Indeed there is God. But at his very critical minded, he did not accept Christianity blindly. He said, as I am going to surrender to God, I have to find the true God. He did not accept Islam immediately. Then he started to study. 2 years, 3 years, 4 years, 5 years, I think 5 years or 6 years, I forgot the exact years, took to study different religions, Christianity, Islam, all this. Finally, he accepted Islam. Okay? So, and it happened to you. You have money, everything, enjoy. Only when you suffer, forgive me. Don't do like that, okay? Allah, there is a hadith Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that anybody remembers me in his or her happy moment, okay, you are so happy, meaning that you have money, you have health, you have father, mother, children, husband, wife, full family, car, house, everything is in order. You remember Allah. Like yesterday I told you, فَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّكَ وَاسْتَغْفِرْ. More and more. What will happen? Prophet ﷺ said, if you do like that, if you remember Allah in your happy time, Allah will remember you in your dangerous time. Meaning difficult time. When you are in critical position, Allah will help you. Very clear message. So please try to make the balance. Okay? Inshallah, Allah will be with us in our danger. May Allah help us in our critical conditions. Ameen.
Ameen.
So, again we remember, if'alu, la taf'al, la taf'alu. Again. If'alu, la taf'al,
la taf'alu.
Again.
If'alu,
okay, now I check whether you understand me or not. Okay? Qira'a or qira'a, you understand, right? Iqra, iqra. If I say iqra, you understand? You understand? Iqra? Okay, if I say iqra'u, you understand?
Yes.
Alhamdulillah. You know the meaning of rahmat, right? So if I say irhamu, you understand? Irhamu? Irhamu? You understand? Meaning all of you show mercy. Okay, irhamu. If I say izhab, zahaba means to go. Zahabun, to go, okay? So izhabu.
Izhabu,
what is the meaning? Go, not now, after 15 minutes. Okay. Not now, 11 o'clock, inshallah. We have to maintain the schedule, okay? Don't cry. Okay, so now we have another discussion. I already discussed. Can anybody see any difference here in the slide? Anybody is blinking or crying?
No.
Somebody is crying, right? Who is that? Who is crying?
Me.
Don't look at Sasha, he's smiling. this one is crying. Me. Me is crying, right? So, me is crying because all others are saying he or she is alone, so cry, okay? So, yes, I already told you in the morning, kitabi is okay, but when it comes after verb, it will be ni. You remember? You remember I told you in the morning already? Ni, daraba ni, nasara ni. Okay, or unsur ni, khalaqa ni, like that. Okay, so all others say. All others are saying. For example, if we say Nasara or Khalaqa, who, no problem. Khalaqa, whom, also no problem. After verb, after noun, all are saying except Ni. Clear? You understand? All other pronouns will be same as we practiced yesterday with noun. Kitabu, who, Khalaqa, who, no change. After verb, after noun, same. Again, kitabuhum, also khalaqahum, no change. Kitabuka, khalaqaka, same. Kitabukum, also khalaqakum. After verb, after noun, same. No problem. But when you say kitabi, you cannot say khalaqai, cannot say khalaqani. Only this one is changed. That's why it's blinking. To focus, to show you that this one is different. This one is different, me, okay? So let's practice with, na is saying, kitabuna, darabana, or khalaqana. Bismillah, now we practice. Now, I give you double exercise. Because I saw some of you don't show your finger. You feel shy or you are not serious. Now, double action. What is that? Khalaqa. On time, finger. Khalaqa. Who? Another time. Khalaqa. Who? He created him. Tell me like this. Khalaqa. Who? He created him. Khalaqa. Whom? He created them. Change the finger. Please. Look. Khalaqa. Whom? He created them. خلقهم. He created them. خلقك. Oh, sorry. خلقك. He created you. خلقكم. He created you all. خلقني. He created me. خلقنا. He created us. خلقها. He created her. Look. Now no way. Your fingers are moving around. Okay. Again, again. If you do more exercise, you will enjoy the breakfast. If you are, if your belly is full, you cannot take more. So enjoy. This is again. خلقه. He created him. خلقهم. He created them. خلقك. He created you. خلقكم. He created you all. خلقني. He created me. خلقنا. He created us. خلقها. He created her. Okay? Because British people don't pronounce R, okay? So, khalaqaha, he created her. Okay, alhamdulillah. We enjoy. Now, go kindly open page number 36 before break. A'udhu billahi minash shaitani rajim. Bismillahi rahmani rahim. قل أعوذ برب الفلق من شر ما خلق ومن شر غاسق إذا وقب ومن شر النفاثات في العقد ومن شر حاسد إذا حسد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل أعوذ برب الفلق من شر ما خلق ومن شر غاسق إذا وقب ومن شر النفاثات في العقد ومن شر حاسد إذا حسد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل أعوذ برب الفلق من شر ما خلق ومن شر غاسق إذا وقب ومن شر النفاثات في العقد ومن شر حاسد إذا حسد. Yesterday we said Kitabun anzalnahu ilayka mubarakun. You remember? Did you observe baraka in your class? Just tell me the truth. You had your seminar, meeting, workshop for your company, right? For a long time. Just try to imagine, try to compare with your workshop where they have variety of programs and compare this workshop. And tell me the truth. Did you observe baraka or not? It's not to make me happy. Just you imagine. Just you be with you. No need to tell me. Just you try to compare. You will get really, really that you don't feel bored. You don't feel, angry. You don't feel that, okay, I have this always. Because a lot of our angels are here, surrounded by Allah. Surrounded by us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent a lot of hadith about it. When any group remembers me, they will be surrounded by angels, subhanAllah. So, inshallah, you have to have that kind of belief. And I hope that you are also enjoying these blessings of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Inshallah. Falaq Nas. Allahu Akbar. Dr. Abdulaziz selected only few surah, but all surah are very important. Asr, yesterday I discussed, is so important. Nasr also very important. Falaq Nas, Fatiha, Ikhlas also very important. Falaq and Nas are called as Al-Ruqiyya Al-Shar'iyya, also Mu'awwizatayn. Okay? Mu'awwizatayn means the one you are getting the protection by reciting it. Okay? These two surah is called Mu'awwizatayn, means by heart you are taking the protection from Allah, from Shaitan to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay? So Falaq, please follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Follow the Sunnah. He used to recite Falaq and Nas after every salah. Three salah, satu kali. Dua salah, tiga kali. Okay, for example, Salatul Fajr, three times. Salatul Maghrib, three times. All other salah, one time. Okay, because Fajr, you are starting the day. Maghrib, you are starting the night. That's why it's more. more, you need more protection, okay? Full day you are going to for your work, for your office, so you are driving, lot of issues. So you recite three times, Allah will protect you. And also before after Maghrib, you recite Surah Falak and Nas three times, inshallah Allah will protect you. All other salah, because short time, just one time, it's okay. Also yesterday I told you to recite Ayatul Kursi. Ayatul Kursi, after every salah, if you recite Ayatul Kursi, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that there is no barrier between him and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, him or her, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, except his death. Means you die, Allah will give you the test of Jannah, even in your qabr, Allahu Akbar. So, please make it as normal habit. Make it as very normal habit. Finish Salat, Ayatul Kursi. Finish Salat, Fatiha, Ikhlas, three times, and then this Surah, Falaq and Nas, as I mentioned, okay? Please make it as your normal habit. Okay? Inshallah, you will get benefit. Let's look what is mentioned here in Surah Falaq. Kul. What is the meaning of Kul? Tell me. Because you already learned a lot. Say. Okay? Katakan la. Okay? Say. Yes, it's so good. Okay? Auzu. I see. Refuse. Or protection. Okay? B. Apa? Dengan. Okay? B. Okay? B. Rab. Lord. Okay? Falak, daybreak. Daybreak is like a changing time. Changing time from night to day. It's called daybreak. Daybreak, okay? Like, you know, before Fajr starts, we have the suhoor time, for example. This short time from night part to daytime. Because Fajr also is the starting of the, it's not like sunshine, but in Arabic calculation, Fajr means the starting of the day, okay? So, the changing from night to day, this changing, it looks very easy because you are not handling it. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows the technique. No scientist can change this practices. They can talk a lot, argue, atheist people or secular scientists, if you go to YouTube, talk a lot. But okay, give me a medicine that I will survive for 1,000 years. Do they have any medicine like that? Can they change this direction of sun, moon? Can they do it? So why they talk a lot? Because they are ignorant. They don't have that knowledge. That Allah did not open their heart for Islam. Okay? May Allah give us tawfiq to understand it properly. Changing from night to day. It's not an easy job. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminded us, I am the Lord of daybreak. Okay? I control these changes. Okay? Mean then what to do? From where we are asking, from what items we are asking protection? Number one, sharri ma khalaq. Negative effects of any creation. For example, Allah created snake. Allah created, the tigers. Allah created lions. Allah created some other animals that is very dangerous. Never be upset. Allah knows why He created. Why He created snakes, why He created lions, why He created tigers. So what to do? We just seek protection. Oh Allah, what You created, You know better. But protect us from any dangerous effect or any negative effect of Your creation. Okay? Because sometimes scientists found some of the issues why Allah created. Some of the snakes' poisons are very good medicine. For cancer or for some other things, okay? So, it is being revealed by researchers, but cannot be revealed one day. You continue, thousands of researchers are doing research, but still new things are coming, new items are coming. Allahu Akbar. Just recently, I read an article in newspaper or online newspaper. Recently, the scientists found that inside the sun, okay, they found the holes, they observed by their monitoring. These were like thousands of this earth or this world can just play like move, okay, like ball. You know, when you play the bubble, for example, with the bubble, They found that this world is so small inside the hole of sand. Okay, for example, they found some holes in the sand. That is, small is like bigger than this earth, this world. Okay, so they will find more and more, because it's unlimited. Allah is the most knowledgeable. He is creating. He is the most powerful. So scientists, those who are claiming something different to our belief, actually they have no knowledge. Yes. They are misguided. That's why they are just trying to do something. Actually, this is not true. And you can check also. That's why yesterday also I told you, Islam is not the name of a belief only. It's practical. The more you know, you will find it practical, inshallah, okay? I told you the example of Inna Lillah. I hope some of you already get the result in your life. Me, I am the example, alhamdulillah, Allah selected me for this. Anytime, just 2-3 times finish, I find the key. Okay, even somewhere I put far, I put, yes, maybe there. Because the angels send me there, okay, like that. Practical, but to get the test of practical Islam, you have to recite, you have to cry, you have to make tawbah, you have to make istighfar, tilawa, zikr. Inshallah, you will be able to make Islam as a practical religion. May Allah give us tawfiq.
Amen.
Min sharri ma khalaq. Whatever Allah created, O Allah, we seek refuge, we seek protection to you from the creation that you created, okay? Wa min sharri ghasiqin idha waqab. Also, O Allah, we seek protection to you from the darkness when it becomes intense. Even no need to talk. You are highly educated, all of you. You understand easily. Even you are, for example, Malaysians. You also don't drive after midnight, for example, because you have some gangsters, young people. You know, they ride motorbike, take your key, like that. Why? Because this time is less secure. Because even security guard, they have to sleep. Okay? So only few petrol police are on the road. Only few. So dark time is dangerous. Okay? So we seek protection from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Oh Allah, protect us from the darkness. Okay? Or the negative effects of the darkness when it becomes intense. Because of, you know, the storm or any other time or even after midnight. Anyway, we seek protection to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Amin shalim nafasati fi lokal. In Bahasa Melayu, nafas you already have, right? Breathing, okay? So, nafasat means blowers. I don't know how to show you. Okay, for example, nafas, uqad is like making like this, okay? So, uqad. So the people who are doing the sihr, okay, they take some small rope or something like that, then they do some kalimatul kufur, and then they tie, okay? So may Allah protect us from this kind of sihr, because sihr is so dangerous. Please remember, if you know anybody, advise him or her, please, not to do again, because sihr is shirk. Sihr is shirk. No doubt in it. Okay, there is shirk, and the punishment of shirk is Jahannam. It's so dangerous. To accept the tawbah of shirk is so tough. Allah subhanahu, until your heart is fully clean, no more shirk, only then Allah can accept. So dangerous. Inna shirka la zulmun azim. Okay, a serious wrong deed. So please, tell your people, if you know anybody doing sihr, no more. Okay? And we also seek protection to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so that Allah protect us from the effect of anyone's sihr. Okay? The people who blow the in the knots. Okay? Amin shari nafasati bi lokal. Amin shari hasidin iza hasad. Also, we ask protection to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the enviers who practice hasad. No more hasad. No. This dunya is only for a few moments, only very short time. So we should not involve ourselves in hasad. So we pray for two things. One is hasad is so that we are protected from hasad of other people. also we should not do hasad. Because hasad burns the good deeds. Hasad burns the good deeds very quickly. So please, please never do hasad with anybody. Also pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah protect us from the hasad of other people. May Allah protect all of us from hasad, from sihr, from darkness, from other negative impact or negative effects of Allah's creation. Ameen. So before we go for break, let's recite Surah Al-Asr and then we go. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات تواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. So,